What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Over the past few months, we managed to cover several tree implementations, and if you take a closer look at the methods within the code we wrote, you will see that most of them heavily rely on recursion. Now, recursion, as in the general concept, was explained and discussed separately on its own. We also tackled tail recursive methods a few weeks ago. So today, what we are going to do is take all of these concepts and apply them in this video, allowing us to truly understand how recursion was used and implemented within the tree methods we previously covered. Let's start by briefly talking about the nature of trees and why recursive logic always seems to be the way to go when trees come up. To do that, let's take a look at this tree. This tree is made of subtrees, and those subtrees are also made of other subtrees, and ultimately all of these subtrees are the same tree. Eventually, we get to a point where the subtrees are just the nodes, and where each node can be considered a tree itself. Because, you see, to traverse a tree, for instance, all you need is one node, and using this single node, you can go ahead and visit all the nodes belonging to that tree. That is actually why a lot of people perceive trees as recursive data structures. Remember how we defined recursion as solving sub-problems of a bigger problem. So, what applies on the general idea, or the tree, also applies on the specific elements, or the nodes, and by traversing these nodes one by one, we are aiming to reach a bigger target, which is traversing the whole tree. And that is exactly what we mentioned in our recursion video. Recursion is all about starting with the specifics and build up in order to solve the larger problem at hand. While implementing trees, we always start with one node, the root node, not a list of nodes. And because of that, we tend to start solving the problem at hand in a specific manner. With this in mind, let's take the in-order traverse operation, for example, and try to implement it for the tree you see. As we mentioned, we'll start by traversing the node we have in particular, or the root node, and then build up this implementation so that it may apply on the whole tree. So, all we have is the root, hence our starting point is a single node and not the whole tree or a list of nodes. Therefore, let's apply what we have in mind on this node only. Okay, to traverse a single node in an in-order manner, what we do is traverse its right child first, then the actual node at hand, then its left child. For the sake of this example, we'll simply be printing out the values stored inside the node. Feel free to add them to a list or do whatever you want with them. Now, what we did here is traverse a single node, but what about the other nodes belonging to the tree? What if they also had children? Take a look at the left child of the root being passed to the method in this new example. This node and its children belong to this same tree. However, in the code we just wrote, we only traversed the parent without taking into consideration the children. So, a more correct implementation of this method would be the one you see in front of you. However, implementations such as these are non-scalable, as you might have guessed. But they do allow you to notice something. The first three lines written here reflect the same exact behavior as the method we started with, but as if, instead of passing to the method the root, we passed its left child. Therefore, the code we wrote can be easily replaced with what you see in front of you. Same applies if the righted child had children nodes. The code it generates can be replaced with a call to the same method we started with. What we did here was not only replace a bunch of duplicate lines of code, but we also made our traversal method scalable. You see, if we were to add additional nodes to the tree, this recursive call will not only take care of the direct children of our root, but also of all the nodes belonging to our tree. However, with every recursive method comes a stop condition in order to avoid stack overflow exceptions, as we mentioned in our previous videos. In this case, we need to keep going down in the tree until we hit a null node. And when that happens, we will know that we've reached the bottom of our tree and that it's safe to start returning with our node's values. Recursion is about applying your logic on the smallest piece at hand and then expand it on the whole problem you want to solve. This same mentality will also apply on the insertion or any other operation we previously implemented in our tree videos. Take the insertion code you see, for instance. If you were inserting a single child under a single parent node, that's what the code would have looked like. The node variable here references the parent, and the new node is the child we want to insert. That's our solution for the insertion of a single node. To expand it on several nodes, or the whole tree, we need to keep iterating over the remaining nodes of this tree by using the left and right child references stored in the single node we started with. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.